The Communist government discovered my little plan, block, music, musician pathway. My parents both were doctors in medical school. Their medical school all shut off except few classes, so they smuggled me in as an illegal student. And I asked my father, I said, why I need to study medicine without having any chance to become a doctor, because I would be deported. My father said, knowledge will always be useful. And to this day, I still remember what he said. So the government discovered this illegal student in the medical school and kicked me out. So at age 15, again, I faced the deportation. Then I met a young man whose father was executed by writing a play against the government. And he was a very talented poet. So we got together. I taught myself music composition. So we wrote many pieces together. Government never allowed us to publish our works. One of the pieces we wrote was Prisoner's Song. Express our longing for freedom, for learning, for future that is better than condemned labor. 1976, the paramount leader died. China realized what a tragic mistake it has made on itself by destroying its youth for 10 years. And that's where I had to jump the entire senior high school to go to college. The way I came to America was my junior year in college, there was going to be a visit by an American professor. And I have my little plan. I want to come to America, but my parents were earning like $6 or $8 a month, so there's no way they can support. So the night before the professor's arrival, I pulled up English textbooks and I studied. Next morning, he gave a lecture. At the end of the lecture, he said, any questions? And I raised my hand very high. There's like 300 Chinese students, all very quiet and disciplined. So he said, yes. And I asked him a question straight out of the textbook that I spent the night before preparing. And the question was, what is the academic load of your school? And he said, what do you mean? What exactly is academic load? You know, can you explain? Then I realized I practiced all night asking a question without practicing how to listen to a question. So I ended up repeating the same question, no clue what he was saying. Finally, he figured out what I was saying, and this, it turns out I did study English textbook the night before, but it was a British English textbook. And that was how Great Britain means, the academic load means the amount of credits an undergraduate is supposed to have to graduate. In America, we probably will describe more specifically. But anyway, he figured out I was saying, he explained, I didn't understand what he was saying. But I did get to ask my question. That was my plan. Before he went off the podium, he goes, that student, I want to see him in America. Because he was impressed by my persistence. Asking the same question 10 times. And 1982, I was dropped at National Airport, Washington, D.C. I had $50, borrowed, and a dictionary, and American dream, knowing no one in this country. Next slide, please, Carlos. Christianity. There are about 70 to 100 million Christians. Historically, there was an opportunity for Christianity to really truly exert its influence in the Yuan Dynasty, 13th century, when around the time of Marco Polo, the Pope sent 4 priests to China together with uncles of Marco Polo. But they went back halfway through the journey because how difficult the journey was. There would have been an opportunity. Today, most of Christians in China can pray openly now, fortunately. Only a few years ago, one has to pray underground. But government make very strict rules that you cannot talk about politics. Today, despite its economic development, because Chinese people is always a people that needs spiritual guidance and moral compass. But yet, with the falling of Berlin Wall, there's a crumbling of communism ideology. We all know it doesn't work. So there's a spiritual vacuum. It is absolutely historical moment for Christian brothers and sisters around the world to venture into China to spread the words of Jesus Christ. I've been involved in translational work for the seventh book, Bible in Chinese. And my contribution was trying to influence it to make the Bible translation Chinese language modern Chinese in order to truly influence the young generation. The language used today is very different from what it used to be. For example, 20 years ago, you say attachment. Oh, emotional attachment. But today, a young person, you say, I will send you attachment. Actually, has a different meaning. So only by capturing the language of our time, we can truly, in translating Bible, we can truly capture the younger generation. Next slide, please. How did I become a Christian? I was not born one. I was not one when I came to the United States, similar to John Wang. And I appreciate John introducing me to the CEO Fellowship. So I searched answers in about things in life through science. And it's interesting that the more I studied, the more I realized that lesser could be explained. So I really got into an emotional, moral crisis. Where's the answer? I thought the more science I studied, the more I would get to know. It is very important one has a good mentor in life. And at that point, there was a professor whom I respect a great deal for his scientific knowledge. He took me out for lunch one day. He knew that I was struggling about the inability, increasing inability of science to explain things. And so he took me out for lunch, and he said, Ming, what's over across the street? I said, that's a car. He said, what's the difference between car and human brain? I said, human brain is much more complex. And he said, do you think a random collection of scrap metals, a pile of random collection of metals will assemble itself into a car? I said, no way. He said, how about human brain? I said, that's even much more unfathomable. He said, you know my point. And this professor really opened the door. Stanley Hand, that's his name, opened the door for me to look into an entirely new world that I was not familiar with. 3 years of studying and watching, observing friends, brothers and sisters who have worked with the Lord much longer than I have, I've learned much, and I still have a lot to learn. But I feel that we could find answers. So my having become Christian has to do with coming with a question and trying to find an answer. Next slide, please. Two lessons I have learned as a Christian. One is God does have a plan for each of us, even though at the time it may not be apparent to us. So for example, if I look back my life at age 18, stray student, yearning for a future of happy life, was so tragically cut off, like 20 million others, that faced the fate of deportation and lifetime misery. Why? What's the purpose of that? At the time, I did not understand. Also, at age 21, came to this country, not knowing anyone, penniless. Why God took me on the other way to the other side of the globe? What's the purpose?